and why? Big city of dreams. I'm an upstate fella with the heart of a king. And I fought up the stings, but I'm partial to playing fame. And blame never change, always remain the same. Yeah, ever since day one, I'm stepping to the plate, wishing they would say something, make something, take something, even fake something. Having one of those days, wishing I could break something. I'm from New York. I'm from New York. Ha ha! That was awesome. What's hood, my peeps? I'm your man, Big Hefe. Welcome to the newly revamped podcast, now called Off the Cuff, where two of your favorite homies from the East Coast get down and dirty on topics you suggested yourself. That's right, Big Hefe hears you out and brings you what you want. Unfortunately, my big homie, Judge Masterpiece, is out this week. He had some business, some family business to handle. As we said before, we're both family men, and family comes first no matter what. And it's totally understood. He should be back and ready to go real soon, all right? So let's get this started right here. Have you ever wanted to make your own podcast? Anchor can help. It's free. The creation tools allow you to record and edit right off your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you. It can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from it too, with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need in a podcast in one place. So download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. So today, I'm going to break this up into four segments. This episode, in which I'll talk about one topic per segment. Sounds good? All right, let's get this started. The first topic is a hot one and has been for a long time, as it should be. Until we reach racial equality, I don't think we should stop talking about Black Lives Matter. Now, before I say how I feel about that, I want to say that I've discussed this issue offline with a few of you, and I value your opinions on it. Some were not ones I completely agree with, but that's okay. But thank you for sharing it with me and in the process helping me grow. That's what it's all about, right? Growing. So first, I want to clarify what BLM, Black Lives Matter, means to say, as I see it. Because I've seen and heard that many people think it means that other races don't matter. All right. That's not it. That's just not it. Because what I think it means, or what I see that it means, Black Lives Matter is that Black people's lives should matter also. Black Lives Matter means that while we all matter in theory, what we're seeing in society is exactly opposite. And when it comes to Black community, there's been people that told me, well, if Black lives matter, why is there so much Black on Black crime? And to that I say, statistically, people commit crimes more within their own race, meaning the victim is more likely to be the same race as the criminal than it is otherwise. In our great nation, there's this thing called justice and liberty for all. But where's the justice for Black people, for Black Americans? Therefore, until Black lives matter in practice, all lives matter. All lives don't matter because they're not part of the word all. We should all take this as a movement for all of us that stand against racism to be an opportunity to learn all of our blended cultures within America, or, you know, food, dance, salsa, because, you know, I'm Puerto Rican. Well, New Yorkian. And, you know, we could say it kind of relates to this in a way. I mean, I'm trying to come up with an analogy. All cancers, you know, when people get cancer, it's terrible. It should be treated with, you know, people with cancer should be treated, should be cared for. And we should be working to get, you know, a cure. But in March, what do we focus on? Well, we focus on breasts. Breast cancer, that is. Although, we all know how men can be around titties. Let's get that straight. And on that note, I think I'll move on, because I just felt a few eye rolls on here. Anyway, this segment, this next segment, I'm going to be talking about the NFL. Ah, the NFL. So much going on in my favorite sport. Let's begin with how COVID-19 has ruined mostly all sports. Some sports may not even have a season this fall. But if they do, they'll likely be following rules called Corona rules. But how do we social distance in football or basketball? I don't know. I sure hope the NFL comes back, though, because that's my jam. You know, it's my outlet. I love to sit around on a winter day eating crabs, drinking Arizona iced tea or Pepsi, because those are my favorite drinks, or Snapple, and just watching the game on TV. And now I would say I did go to games, and I liked it when I lived in Maryland, and now I live in Michigan. And no, I'm not a Lions fan yet, but you know, I do support them. I do root for them. Don't get mad at me. Anyways, everybody really kind of knows, you know, everybody should know what team I'm a fan of. And that team right now is actually, well, doing a little revamping themselves. I'm kind of looking forward to it, though. Fresh start, maybe. Maybe the team could be called the Washington Red Wolves, which I like, by the way, instead of the Washington Redskins, because, you know, the Washington Redskins, that name, let me just say, and by the way, for those of you wanting to know what my take is on the whole name change, I'll let you know. You can agree with me or not. It's about time we did this, though. That's what I think. Back in 2014, I've been known to say, no, don't change the name, and adamantly so. And I know a lot of people who think, or I should say who don't think it's offensive, and don't feel that Native Americans think it is either. Now, I don't know a lot of Native Americans. I think I may know maybe one or two, maybe. I know I've met one for sure in my life. I don't see him a lot. I gotta say, I'm in Michigan now. Michigan has a lot of names that have to do, like Shiawassee, and you know, have to do with Native Americans and stuff like that. But Chippewa and, you know, those kind of names. But I haven't met a lot of people that are Native Americans. And shout out to Native Americans out there. You know, I appreciate every culture. I wish that what happened to Native Americans out there recently, actually, where, you know, they were beat up, you know, treated poorly, very poorly. I really, my hearts go out to their families, to their tribes. And so my heart has changed since 2014. I think that, you know, it's derogatory. You know, it's not a good name. Okay. I said it here because I want you to know that I, you know, what team I was a member of. So I'd said it in the football sense, okay? And I don't want to anybody to think that that I said it out of being racist myself or anything like that, because I totally am against that. And you, I'll touch more on that later. But anyway, I've been thinking about, so the name is, I'm sorry, it's derogatory. I'm sorry, and I'm not sorry, you know, it's derogatory. It's not the name of a tribe. You know, you have other teams, high school teams, football teams, baseball, you know, pros and not pros that are named after tribes. And I don't think that that's racist. I think that's actually honoring, you know. And like I said, I know a lot of you guys' opinion out there and you know, it's racist. Okay, period. Change it. Change the damn name. That's all I got to say about that. But anyway, I've been thinking about this last topic a lot lately because, well, I'm a proud American Army and Navy veteran. Okay, very proud. I love that I served my country. I feel that people should serve their country. However, at one point in my life, with all the fucked up shit going on in America, I lost my pride in the people of this country that I signed on a dotted line to defend when shit goes down with other countries. I mean, seriously, that's what I did. At 17 years old, I had to get my mother's permission, but at 17 years old, I was willing to put my life on the line for this country. I know a lot of people, black, white, whatever they are, that have done this. And I think it's such a noble thing to do. I'm not saying that if you don't do it, as I've been accused of before, of saying that if you don't do it, that you're less, your opinion matters less, or, you know, you're less of a person. That's not true. Okay. I value people. I don't think everything's for everybody. Okay. But when I came out of the military, I thought that everybody should experience it at least once in their life. Of course, that would mean that, you know, we'd have to have a dictator saying, hey, you know, everybody has to go into the military at 18 or something like that. But anyway, that's just something that was on my mind. And at this point, basically, the reason it was on my mind is because of the next segment. And we're going to go ahead and transition to that now. So in this next segment, it's going to be the last one. Actually, no, I'm sorry. It's not going to be the last one. It's going to be the second to last one, because then we got another thing going on. So we're going to have a little fun. So I'm going to go ahead and tell you what America means to me in this next segment. But before I get to, you know, into the mushy part of what America means to me, let me first say that I feel like we've crossed the line between what is ridiculous and what is normalcy in this country. Because people just do and say ridiculous shit now. And it goes viral. And it's accepted as cool and all that bullshit. Like, people who wear their pants down to their ankles. Okay, when I was young, it was down to maybe off your butt a little bit. And I still thought that was ridiculous. Now, oh my God. Okay, you're showing me your boxers. You're showing me things I don't want to freaking see. Okay, cover that shit up. You know, it's the most ridiculous shit I've seen. And it's just something that for some reason society has accepted. Okay, maybe, I mean, I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people that feel like I do. So, you know, when you see that, don't accept it. As a matter of fact, I have a story about that. My wife, who a lot of people that know us, they love my wife. She is a no-nonsense. She's awesome. I mean, she really is. She just is, you know, she's tough. She's a tough woman. And we were at this party once, and there was a guy who, a family friend, it was a family party. And a guy came by and said, "Excuse me, ma'am." And he was maybe about 16, 17. It was one of my cousin's friends. And she looked up at him and said, "I'll move when you put those pants up." Pull those pants up. And everybody kind of like stopped for a second and looked to see what the kid was going to do. And, you know, he did. He pulled them up. Now, he pulled them up and they kind of slid a little bit back down. I don't know what they do with these pants to, you know, they slip them up, they put them down, you know, I don't know. But he pulled them up and I was like, wow. Because I was ready to go. I was ready to tell this kid off if he told my wife anything crazy out her name or anything like that. But yeah, man, come on. Everybody says it's a fad, you know, or most people say it's a fad. No, it's not a fucking fad, okay? I'm sorry to tell you. Pull your pants up, dickheads. Come on. You know, who the hell wants to see your ass crack? Who the hell wants to see your ass, period? I don't care what kind of boxers you have on. Polka dots, stripes, you know, fucking whatever. I don't care. Pull that shit up. Anyway, so I'm off my soapbox there for a second. But so another thing that's kind of ridiculous in this world, though, is people now are so much more brash than they used to be, I think. You know, you see these videos on YouTube and online, and it's just people doing crazy stuff. You got world star hip hop, or what is it, world star hip hop, whatever it is, world star, I think it's called. But anyways, you got people recording stuff that is just crazy. I mean, you know, people going up to people, calling them out of their name. People you don't even know. I mean, they don't even know. They don't know nothing about these people. I mean, they don't know their life history. You know what I mean? Their walk in life. They could be going through some shit. So I say, treat people the way you want to be treated. I mean, that's always something that was said before when you were little. I'm sure everybody's heard that. Treat people the way you want to be treated. I mean, honestly, I'm pretty sure you wouldn't want to be treated disrespectfully. So what makes you think other people want to be treated disrespectfully, right? I mean, it's just common sense, people. It's just common sense. So I'm not here to rant, though, about that right now. Well, I mean, I will, because this is off the cuff. So, but I'm going to tell you right now what America means to me. And, you know, hope you... I mean, look, if you disagree with me, that's fine. I don't care, to be honest. I don't think we're all meant to agree with everything. I don't think we ever will. So let me tell you, I think America is supposed to be a melting pot. All right. And when I see people from all different backgrounds, I see something like a human kaleidoscope. It's pretty. It's vibrant, you know, it's different, okay? We're all humans from different backgrounds. It's okay to see color and take it in as face value and appreciate it. It's okay to learn about the different origins we all come from. It's okay to be of any cultural descent and still say, hey, say this proudly too. I'm American. I'm proud to be an American. You know, I'm of Puerto Rican descent, okay? I joke around about, you know, oh, Puerto Ricans this and Puerto Ricans that, Americans this, Americans that, but we're American, okay? We're actually the only Latino group, okay? And I'm not boasting because if you're here, you were born here and you are of like Dominican descent or Cuban descent or Colombian, you're freaking American, okay? Just say it. I mean, be proud of that, you know, and also be proud in your culture, you know, but we also have a culture here. It's a melting pot culture, okay? You know, we all love tacos. We all love, you know what I'm saying? We all love Chinese food. Come on, just, you know, I know it sounds liberal and all this stuff people are going to say, but I'm not going to get into that right now, you know, but... yeah, just you know, that's what America is should be to me. Like, we don't all have to agree on everything. Like I said earlier, you know, we won't because it's America. I mean, we are free to think. other countries don't get that. You know what I mean? So just learn from each other, grow, see things from different perspectives, okay? Every once in a while, you got to look at it from a different perspective. And I think it just makes you grow if you do that. And remember this, if you don't remember anything else from this episode, a little empathy and compassion go a long way. All right? And now it's time for shout outs. All right. So my first shout out this weekend is to Chris Lewis, otherwise known as CL, baby. CL on SoundCloud. He's a friend of mine from this old group on the internet, which was called Redskins Heads. And it was either Redskins Heads or Redskin Heads, but he's a musician. And he graciously allowed me to use his music for the intro and the outro of this episode. And I love his music. I think it's fun. And the man can rap. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
And speaking of people from that group, I met a lot of good people in there. I met Robert from New Mexico. I met Drew from Washington State, Nikki from Maryland, and Diana from Maryland as well, I think, Maryland, D.C. area. So, and a host of others. I mean, I think there was a guy named Michael Wask who I met. I think he's in Maryland, too. We all, see each other occasionally on Facebook every once in a while. You know, we exchange hellos, and I just hope they are all doing well in this game we call life. And also, I want to shout out to my wife and kids. All right. You know, look, I've said this before. I've said this many times, but I don't say it just to say it. I don't say it for praise. I'm happy if you think I'm a good father. I'm happy if you think I'm a good husband. But at the end of the day, man, ultimately, it comes down to what my wife thinks, what my kids think to me. Okay. I am in debt to my wife, just supporting me. And I joke with her and say, you don't support me, but she does. I mean, I do all these things. Let's face it, men, we're big babies. Okay. Especially when we get sick. And I know that. And when the women in our lives come through for us, our mothers, our wives, we have to give them that praise. Okay. And I do give my wife so much credit for putting up with me.
Yay!
And with that said, man, you know, I love them to death, and that will never, ever waver. My kids are the most important things in my life. Okay. And with that, I'm going to tell you, like Snoop and Dr. Dre said, man, hope you're ready for the next episode, because we're going to be discussing another couple of suggested topics. Judge Masterpiece will be back. This is going to be hopping. All right. You don't want to miss it. As always, we remind you that you can email us at offthecuffpodcast@gmail.com. Let me say that again, because I think I screwed that up. offthecuffpodcast@gmail.com. Or hit me up on IG at BigHefe75. And you can hit the judge up on Twitter at PendergrassProd. All right? PendergrassProd. And what we're going to be talking about next week is, you know, something that was suggested. Obviously, as I said before, a lot of the topics are suggested, which I love to hear people, you know, wanting to hear what I want to talk, what they want me to talk about, which is great. One is going to be about God, raising kids with faith, okay, being involved in the family. And I'm going to tell you what I think about all that. You know, you may be shocked to hear what I think. You may not be. You may already know, but you can't miss it, man. Don't miss it. And we'll also be talking about domestic violence. That's another suggested topic. It was actually suggested by my cousin. I don't know if she wants me to say her name, but I'm going to say it anyways, Maria. And she's in Boston, Massachusetts, I believe. So, but shout out to you, my cousin. So, yeah, I'm going to definitely try and hit up all those subjects. And I'm so happy that you guys missed us, because we did miss a week. But this time, you only got me. You're going to get the judge next time. And we're going to be having fun as we usually do. So, you know, as I said in the promo, we want to be real, you know, from the rooter to the tutor. You know what I'm saying? I heard somebody say that and I thought it was funny. So, yeah. So I'll see you next time. Hopefully we can bang out another episode before the week is over. Maybe that'd be cool. All right. Thanks for listening. Talk to y'all later. Peace.